big guard.
What is our game missing first? I'm going to leave you with that question. What is our game missing? What is the NBA missing?
The overall game. Man. What I mean, the NBA. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's missing, like, the overall game. Meaning, now it's an era of 3-point. It used to be an era of just 2-point.
Right.
Why can't it be a...
Why can't it be all in one? Well, why did it have to go from dumping it in the post and getting the closest shot at the rim to now we're going to take the farthest shot from the rim? We really never even got in between, have we? You think we ever got? Did the mid-range ever have its time? Even when Kobe was shooting, it did. Iverson, Kobe, T-Mac, Melo,
CP.
CP. Yeah. We had our mid-range game. So you said they haven't once, like, failed to put it, like, let's put it all together. Let's play basketball.
Exactly. That's why not.
Yeah.
And small guards.
Why can't
I don't feel like we've had our time ever.
We never had our time.
I feel like it's going there, but it's not at the same time.
We can't say it's going there when guys like Chris Clemens is going drafted.
But he's in the league.
He's in the league, but he's went undrafted. You got the opportunity to get drafted. Like, you really got an opportunity that slipped from a lot of guys.
Getting drafted really doesn't mean nothing unless you're a lottery. To me, that's what I feel like.
But it do mean somebody's giving you their word or they're calling your name. So they obviously, your name is around in
but it's other ways to make your name. It's other ways to make
Tell
your name.
Tell them how to make your name. How you making it? You lead the nation in scoring, statistically, the number-wise, but the people that orchestrate the game love. How do you? I'm here. I can play. 5'9", but I can play. I'm here. Do you come out as arrogant as? Not saying you came out arrogant, but a lot of people say your approach was arrogant. You name dropped. Then you airdrop. Then you name drop Ben Simmons.
Listen.
You said Ben Simmons. I average more than him.
Got to.
You name drop. You got a name drop.
It's facts though. I didn't speak nothing fictional.
Hey,
that was my whole thing. I didn't speak nothing fictional. I believe in myself. And doing that video, they was trying to like, we should get so-and-so to do it. Nah, I want to do it. This is me. I'm talking about me.
Okay.
So, I mean, and they want to do it. It was cool doing it, yeah. But this is me. This is my life. This is
you know, I feel my like career. That. I feel like that video helped you, though. Like, I offered that type of thing to Marcus King. I thought that's something he should have did.
Yeah, you should have done.
You got to do that. You average 30. You don't get drafted. You don't get an invite to the combine. That's a smack in the face. Dear NBA, you're coming. I'm posting you. I'm taking the Antonio
That's
Brown.
That's what you should have named it.
Yeah, I'm taking the Antonio Brown approach without the chaoticness that Antonio Brown brings. But I like how he uses his platform. Facts. You can put out facts. Facts is not being arrogant. Remember that. That's from Kay Felder himself. If you state facts, it's not arrogant, it's not no shade, it's the reality, you know what I'm saying? So I like the name. I actually like the name dropping video. It was like one of the most, like when I remember Kay Felder, like, yeah, all the accolades you hear, but you know, Oakland don't get that much TV time, so it's not real to you.
You ain't heard about him since I left. Okay, wait, my bad. Kendrick Nunn, shout out to my boy Kendrick.
Kendrick Nunn, hey, Miami Heat.
He definitely put on.
Hey, all facts. All facts, no fiction, man. That's how we rocking over here, man. All facts, no fiction. So you say you got to sell yourself. So the game misses smaller guards. And you say just the overall, like, playing basketball. Making the right reads. Like, taking a pull-up.
Exactly.
Can't get too deep. You might got to take the pull-up. Might got to shoot the pull-up. Yeah. But you know what? I think we're there. We're heading there. Like you said, we're heading there. But they got to get a big guard they shot.
Because, I mean, don't get me wrong. Guys shoot it, yes, but...
They don't shoot like that, bro.
And they feel like, don't get me wrong, 3 is definitely more than 2.
It is.
And that's what it is, okay? We shoot more 3s than you do.
Don't make it an easier shot.
But that's not an easier shot, like.
It's not, it is.
I'm sorry. Like, and they say, like, the percentage is not. Okay.
But the numbers people. Like, I was told through the grapevine.
First of all, I'm not with the numbers people. I don't. Yeah. Kiss my ass.
Okay, well, not with the number of people, but you know, he had to let you know he having more than Ben Simmons, more assists, you know. The big
points,
points, all of that. So, yeah, I think the game ain't got nothing like that. Nobody in that 2-point range that's really like dominating besides CP3. CP3 still taking his two.
Kawhi
still taking his two.
Rose
still taking his two.
But it's limited though.
It's limited.
A guy have a pull up and try to get to the rim. If he don't get to the rim, then he dribbling all the way out.
Or they extra step back.
For three.
They taking an extra step back. They taking it. That's why these extra steps that's being created, I feel like they're created to get behind the line.
To be successful in today's game, you gotta be able to shoot the long ball.
Gotcha. Work on your deep ball. Shout out Curry, man. Curry is one of the grandfathers. That's why Curry is one of the GOATs, man. Curry is goated. Don't sleep, don't disrespect. Curry is one of the greatest of all time. And when you see a GOAT next to his name, hey, he gonna go up there next to LeBron, next to Jordan, all of them, because he changed the game, man. I think when you change the game, your on-court play is just extra, bro. You playing on court is just extra to your name. But when you change the game, like when you change the culture, when you Allen Iverson in the game, bro, it's that.
How can people not love you?
I think Kay needs to use more of his platform to tell these young guys like Chris Clemens and Marcus King, these smaller guys, because we're known for getting buckets. Small guys just find a way to score. I think I was reading one of your draft reports and it was like, yeah, he can really score the basketball. Like, that's your GQ. But I think for all small guards.
My thing is, look, though, this is a crazy thing. People always talked about my scoring. I led the country in assists.
In assists, yeah.
So I don't get how that, like, yeah, I'm scoring, but I'm also assisting. Like, so
but
how can y'all not add that in there?
But you don't average 24, 25, right? What you average. You're not getting drafted, bro. I'm sorry. You can average 12. If you would have averaged 12, 13 assists and your points would have came down like 18, it would have been like, he on the draft board, but his name not getting called. Them buckets matter. Let's not act like the game is.
No, the buckets matter.
How can we find a way to make assists more highlighted in the stats? Like, should we start adding to people points in a way? Like, how should assists be like, added? Like, shouldn't it be like you get a portion of the point for making a shot, and then I get a portion of the point for like assisting it? Cause some, you don't think so?
Some shots
is like, yeah, I gave that one. You know what I'm saying? Like, I gave that one. You know what I'm saying? That was really my two. You know what I'm saying? If I got 28, I'm gonna take this layup for the 30. But you know, I like when I see younger guards, like when they on a break, right, and they got somebody trailing them that could just showtime it.
Yeah.
That they can get the layup, but they throw it back for the showtime. I love that. I love that. That's like the ultimate, like, this the game. I'm playing the game from the perspective. Yeah. If I'm not about to fly here, come on, go up on the show. Because it's a show. It's entertainment, bro. We live in America. Entertainment base.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, put on a show. I think that's what it is. So, I think the game getting there. I think this next generation, I think the Kobe in detail that paved the way for big guard, that paved the way for all the people that use their platform to break down the game and show people the game from different perspectives. I think the next generation of hoopers that's coming up under that umbrella, the detail, we watching the game. Even ESPN is bringing down the game now. You watch ESPN, they got the new effects. Well, ESPN got new effects. They got the 2K player circle around the player, then they draw to what the player is seeing, how they take the shots. Oh, ESPN effects is crazy, bro. Crazy, bro. They breaking down the game crazy.
I just watch the games. Once the game's off, turn the TV off, man.
Yeah. No, it's been breaking down the game. So those younger, you remember when we was younger, you would wake up the Sports Center.
Yeah.
They'll replay the episode 50 times. You still watch it. You know what I'm saying? You still come in your room and hit it out. Same dude showing the same clips. You like, man, you went crazy last night. Those guys who's living like how we live, bro, they're getting that. So they're going to be able with those 5, 6, 7, 8. The ones that's coming up going to be the best we ever seen, bro. Ever. Ever. I mean, they're going to have everything, bro. They're going to be able to fly. Oh, everybody fly now, by the way.
Yeah.
Everybody got their mileage points, freaking flyers. We got those, man. So that next generation, they're going to have to jump or two, because you got to shoot, bro.